I'd like to share with you a new technique for quieting the mind. Okay. When you practice quiet mind, you just like be here now, be the silence, be the awareness, relax. And when the mental chatter starts, it's like you are talking to yourself in your head, right? It's like, okay, I'm going to try this. Okay. Little things will pop up. We normally think of it as ourself talking to ourself. And it's very natural and normal, and it doesn't feel like an ego or an entity or anything is talking. It seems like me babbling away, mental babble, mental chatter, subvocal talking in words. Okay. So that's what we want to eliminate. We're trying to quiet the mind and be here now as the awareness. Okay. Simple technique. As you be aware and you start to mentally chatter, be aware of what you're chattering or saying and mimic it. Like when we were kids, somebody would say something and we'd say the same thing. Hey, don't do that. Hey, don't do that. Shut up. Shut up. I don't like when you copy me. I don't like when you copy. Same thing. But you're doing it to the mental babbler. That aspect of yourself, whether it's called the ego or just another part of you or an entity or whatever. It doesn't matter what we label it. When you're sitting there trying to be quiet, be here now, and you'll get this, it could be very light or it could be very loud, but it's like, okay, I'm doing it. And you go, the awareness that you are duplicates that. Okay, I'm doing it. It's starting to, what happens is, for me, the way it worked for me, this is why I'm sharing it with you, because it worked. What happens is that the compulsive talking gets annoyed with being duplicated or copied like that. And the awareness that you are, or that I am, is intending the exact same thought, words, communication that the compulsive thinker, thinking aspect of self is doing. Okay, I'm doing it. You'll get that mental chatter. Okay, I'm doing it. What now? This isn't working. When you notice that you're thinking these thoughts, just repeat them. What happens is that that part of you that does the mental chatter doesn't like it. And it tends to shut up. And it can't complete the sentence either. So you'll have a long sentence or a thought, and you say, hey, I don't know if this is going to work or not, but I'm going to give it a try. You might be thinking that in your head. But when you get to the part where, hey, I don't know if this is good, the awareness that you are is aware of the thinking self thinking this thought. And the awareness that you are knows the entire thought before it even gets said. So the awareness that you are just throws it in again, repeats, starts at the beginning, cuts off the long sentence, so to speak, and duplicates, says the first parts of it again, just to the part where it got cut off. Oh, I don't think this will work. Maybe that's what the thinking self is thinking to say. The thinking aspect of self puts it into words in your head, in your consciousness, and it starts to say the entire sentence in words, and it's going to take a little time. The awareness that you are is watching. And when it sees, it can feel it and see it, and as the words start to spin out, the awareness that you are, instead of being aware of the entire sentence being said, stops and starts the sentence from the beginning again and takes it as far as to the point where it got cut off. That makes sense, right? So I have the thought, as I think it's working. But the awareness that I am is all aware of this, and it cuts the thought at, I think it, and I just repeat intentionally, consciousness intentionally thinks the thought. I think it's, and in a way to mimic or copycat or duplicate the compulsive thinking. So that's the technique. It's real simple. It's that short. You got to try it. What happened, the first things that started happening as I was doing it is, well, first it tunes up the awareness. And it gets the awareness that you are more aware of the compulsive thinking, the thinking that we can't turn off. It doesn't matter if you call it yourself, another you, an entity, or the ego self, or what. It doesn't matter the labels. You become aware of this compulsion or urge to think the thoughts in your head. So not only that, but now you consciously do what you were unconsciously doing. In other words, you're consciously beginning the sentence over again, that sentence that was compulsively done on a subconscious impulse level. The phenomena that's in play here that works is any activity that you're doing compulsively or subconsciously, you want to take over the automaticity of it. It's something that's going on automatically. The mind and the consciousness and the mental stuff is causing this thing to happen. So you become aware of it. You take responsibility for it. You know more about it. And you can control it by doing it consciously, what you're doing unconsciously. Do it on purpose. Consciously take over what you're doing subconsciously. And this gains that awareness so that you can break the automaticity or the habit and do something differently. So we're using basically the same kind of technique on quieting the mind, the mental chatter, which is going on automatically or compulsively. So just copycat, mimic the sentence or the thought. And you got to tell me what happens when you do this. I'm really interested in this. What I noticed is that I'm becoming very aware of this other part of me that seems like me. This talking me seems like me. Yet there's other awareness aspect of myself that is not this. But yet it is the awareness here. And it feels really good, but it's a way for the awareness to separate out from and stop identifying with the personality, the character, the person that we think we are. It's pretty amazing stuff. So I want to hear what happens when you practice this stuff, okay? All right. Take care now. Talk to you later. Comment. Let me know.